welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make interesting fried rice which has a secret ingredient which I will tell you, because you have to watch until end. And it's a Japanese style fried rice. Okay, so the ingredients I will play now, I will show you the video now, and then let's
fried rice. You need leftover rice. This is one day old rice, short grain rice, carrot, onion, two eggs, mushroom, spring onion white, pork belly. You can use ham, or you can use cured pork. So I just had this belly pork, so I am using this one. Garlic, freshly crushed black pepper, soya sauce, and sake. So let's start, guys. So my wok is nice and hot. So first thing we go is the pork belly. As I said, you can use smoked ham or smoked beef, anything which is smoked or related to pork. So I didn't have the ham or smoked pork, so I'm using this. Okay, so in a very hot pan, just add this and don't put any oil. Let it get render. So after some time, it will release its own oil. So fry until they are nicely brown in color. So now at this stage, as you can see, it's nice and brown. It's cooked well, so the natural oil is come out. So now this stage, you have to add your garlic. Don't use any oil until if it is required. So this oil is enough, and all the flavor is in the oil. So garlic, your chopped onion, okay, cook it until the onion and your garlic also get a nice brown color, okay, at a very high flame. At this stage, as you can see, the onion and everything is nice and brown. So you can add your mushrooms, okay, then your carrot. Okay, make sure everything is cooked well. Let it get cooked. At this stage, I will add spring onion whites. Okay, if you are using ham or if you are using any smoked meat, smoked pork, check your salt at this stage, because I'm using a pork belly. I need some salt, so at this stage I will add some pinch of salt, and then later we will taste as we finish the dish. Okay. So let it get cooked. So guys, this is ready. As you can see, all the vegetables are nicely cooked. Just transfer all of this in another bowl. Okay, so I didn't use any extra oil until now. So after this, don't clean your pan because all the flavor is over there. So now just add some oil. Okay, add some oil, and your eggs will go first. Your beaten egg. If you are not good with your chopstick, you can do it with your fork. So with this, okay, and the oil is nice and hot, just drop it. Okay, and then just with the chopstick, just have to do like this. Don't cook it too. At this stage, you can add your rice. Always use the leftover rice, because it's very good for your taste, and it has that different kind of flavor which is very useful for the fried rice. Okay, so what I'm going to do is combine my eggs and rice, let the rice get nice and hot, and then I will add my the cooked vegetable. Okay, at this stage you can put the crushed pepper, okay, and your soya sauce. Don't put soya sauce in the vegetable because the vegetable color will turn into black and it will not good out in looking when you plate as well. So just have this dark soya sauce. So after this stage you can add your sake. Okay, once the sake is there, so there is time to put the vegetable in. Okay, mix, combine everything together. Okay, after this, the secret ingredients what I was talking about is this Japanese mayo. So like a little bit. Okay, and mix together. Your fried rice is ready. Thank you all guys for watching my videos. So this is how it is done, and I hope you'll try to do this at home. And please let me know in the comment. Please do like, share, subscribe, and share with your loved ones. And stay safe, stay blessed, and very, very important is stay positive.